The leaders of South Korea and Japan are holding their first summit in 12 years. Well, let's go live to Seoul now to speak to our correspondent Jean McKenzie and also Shaima Khalil, our Tokyo correspondent, joining us live from Tokyo.
Well, this visit comes after South Korea announced that it was going to compensate its own citizens for forced labor in Japan's factories during wartime. It's a controversial decision that angered many in South Korea, but was hailed here in Japan and the United States. What we're seeing now is those two countries revamping the relationship, and it could not have come at a more crucial time. As you say, earlier today, North Korea fired an ICBM, an intercontinental ballistic missile, its fourth this week, and no doubt North Korea is going to be top of that agenda.
Now, it's very possible that North Korea has chosen this morning to launch this missile because of this summit, because it doesn't like its so-called enemies working more closely together, but it is proving exactly why they need to cooperate more closely. And South Korea and Japan know that they stand to benefit if they share their intelligence and if they have their militaries work together. There is more security threat than just the threat posed by North Korea. This is also about China too. South Korea and Japan have a lot more in common now than they have that divides them. They are key United States allies, and the US has been pushing them for a long time to work more closely together as it tries to pull together all its partners across the Indo-Pacific to combat this rise of China.
They have a lot to talk about: North Korean threats, China's expansion and military ambitions in the region, and of course, trade relations that have also dried up. Essentially, these issues are going to continue. These historical tensions are going to continue. But this is signifying to the region and also to their common ally in the United States that they're willing to put their fraught history aside to face the threats that they have together in common in the present.